In the last video, I showed you how to solve a particular type of first order equation called a separable first order equation. It's always useful to see how it actually works for an example. So let's try an example today. We have a differential equation, y prime plus y squared sine x equals 0, with an initial condition y of 0 equals 1. So we have to look at the differential equation and try to figure out if it's separable or not. Can we write that as some function of y times dy equals some function of x times dx? So many times you have to manipulate a little bit. So let's change to the Leibniz notation. So we have dy dx for y prime. And then we can write that as minus y squared times sine x. And I want to now write this as some function of y times dy equals some function of x times dx. We can do that if we divide through by y squared. So we can write this as 1 divided by y squared times dy, right? Treating dy dx like a fraction. And that will be equal to minus sine x times dx. Okay, so we've gotten this equation now in its separated form. A function of y times dy equals a function of x times dx. Then we integrate. We have to use the initial condition. Y of 0 equals 1. So we integrate from x equals 0. So we can integrate here from x equals 0, 0 here, to x. And then when y is 0, y at x equals 0 is equal to 1. So this one then gets integrated from 1 to y. Okay. So we have these two integrals to do now. We have the integral of 1 over y squared dy. And we have the integral of sine x dx. So the integral of 1 over y squared is the integral of y to the minus 2 power. So it's y to the minus 1 power divided by minus 1. So we get 1 minus 1 over y. And that will be between 1 and y. So that's the integral of the left-hand side. The integral of minus sine x, if you remember, the derivative of cosine x is minus sine x. So the integral of minus sine x is just cosine x. So we get equal to cosine x from 0 to x. We can put in the limits here. So we have minus 1 over y minus minus 1. So plus 1 equals cosine x minus cosine 0. So cosine x minus cosine 0 is minus 1. We want to solve this for y. So we have cosine x minus 2 minus 1 over y. I can write it out. Minus 1 over y equals cosine x minus 2. We multiply through by minus 1, and we take the reciprocal. So we get y then is equal to, take the reciprocal, multiply by minus 1, so 2 minus cosine x. So y is equal to 1 divided by 2 minus cosine x. And that's the analytical solution. We found y as a function of x. It's nice to at least check the initial condition. Y of 0 equals 1. Y of 0 is 1 over 2 minus 1, which is 1. And then this equation will, this solution also solves the differential equation. Okay. Let me summarize. You're given a differential equation with an initial condition, a first order equation. You want to see if the equation is separable. Not all first-order equations are separable. But if it is separable, it's one of the simpler methods to solve first-order equations. So we can manipulate the equation algebraically with the goal of having a function of y times dy equals a function of x times dx, treating dy dx like a fraction. Here, if we pull everything on the right-hand side, we see that the right-hand side is some function of y times some function of x, and that means it's separable. We divide through by y squared, we multiply by dx, and then we integrate. When you integrate, you just apply the initial conditions and you put limits on the integral. Many times you can actually do the integrals for simple enough equations. If you do the integrals, then you can evaluate them at their limits, and then also many times you can solve for y. So you could get blocked. Maybe you can't do the integral. Maybe you can't solve analytically for y. That happens quite often. But when you can do the integral, you can solve analytically for y, then you can have a very nice closed form solution. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.